Hi, this is Shreya Paliwal.
This is Tanvi Dev.
This is Hemant Gugate. We are the students of Avantika University.
And today we are going to present to you the golden ratio, which is our maths project. Now I am going to demonstrate how some popular artists use golden ratio in their works. This is painting by Michelangelo. He used golden ratio, which is basically a ratio of two numbers that is equivalent to 1.618, which is derived from Fibonacci series, which is 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So he used golden ratio to present his work in such a way which will feel very attractive to the observer. This is the painting in which he has self-portraited his face using golden ratio. The height and width, the height from his chin to his skull and from eye to his chin is in golden ratio. Another painting which is very famous is, of course, Mona Lisa. He used golden ratio to portray Mona Lisa in such a way that it is very famous. Another painting by Da Vinci is his self-portrait, which uses golden ratio, which starts from his between his eyebrows and goes on from his hat to his beard. Another painting is by Da Vinci, which is John the Baptist. You have seen his arm pointing upwards, which is actually use of golden ratio. So now golden triangle.
Golden triangle is basically obtained from the golden star. The golden star is obtained from the Vitruvian man. If we join the points in the Vitruvian man, we get the golden star. And if we connect the points in the golden star, we get the golden spiral. So the ratio of R is to S is in golden ratio. Again, the ratio of R is to S is in golden ratio. If you look at the golden star, there is a triangle over its head. If you look at the triangle, it's an isosceles triangle. If we see its hypotenuse and base, it is in golden ratio. It has been used in many paintings by Leonardo da Vinci. There is a golden point on the world. If you look at the map, the distance from the city Mecca to the North Pole and the distance from Mecca city to the South Pole is in golden ratio. We have tried to calculate the golden ratio with calculating the distances. If you look at the globe, if you look at the Mecca city on the map, diagonally, the distance from Mecca city to both the diagonal end of the diagonals is in golden ratio. Apart from that, there are 21 ancient structures around the globe in golden ratio. They form a circle spiral around the globe. Giza, Petra, Mohenjo-daro, Khajuraho, and Nazca tracks. The distance from Giza to North Pole and Nazca to North Pole, they form a ratio which is the same ratio found in the pyramids of the world. If we take this as A, this as B, then if we multiply it with golden ratio, we get this C. Again, if we take this as A, this as B, and multiply it with golden ratio, we get this as C. Hence, they all are in golden ratio around the globe.
To study the golden ratio in architectures, we have chosen the example of Parthenon temple, which is in the Greece, which is the perfect example of golden ratio in architectures. So each section means in the bottom to the pole, starting of the pole, which is in golden sections, and to the top of the temple, it is in golden sections. So if as a game, we have cut it to the part as a golden rectangles to just play the games and join the temple to get the full golden rectangles using spirals. We can also show here the spirals. So first of all, golden ratio to find to find the correct image of the parallel temple, we can connect these squares to each other to, as shown in the golden rectangles with spiral to get the perfect image. We can also play it as a game. Yeah. The second one thing is the Leonardo da Vinci's the famous painting Mona Lisa. We have painted in Mona Lisa painting with acrylic color, and the main thing is that we have measured each section of her face and to the jaws and all the things with in ratio, the golden ratio. We can see here the all over focus of these pictures in her eyes. This golden spiral starts from her eyes and expands to her chin and then goes on. The golden section is that her face and up to her that half of the body, this section and this section is in golden section, golden ratio. Yeah. The third thing is that icosahedron, which is made using three rectangles having the dimension of golden ratio. So if these three rectangles having the golden ratio form at the Fibonacci sequence 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, we have chosen the consecutive number in the Fibonacci sequence which perfectly suits to the dimension of this rectangle to fix it in each other. If we fix these three rectangles from that the center of the three rectangles will be same, then we get the form at the icosahedron. When we join the each edges of the rectangle, we get the icosahedron. Okay, yeah.
We have also equilateral triangles over here, and we get golden rectangles and a golden spiral using this. We would like to conclude that we extended our research to golden ratio, golden star, golden triangles, golden spirals. In Da Vinci's work and many other artists and architectures around the world.
And we have enjoyed a lot for making this, making these paintings and models. We have enjoyed a lot.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.